meet Dan Dixon, the owner of Crewners, which is located at the San Pedro Square Market. Dan, it's so nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, Judy.
I'd like to have a little bit of history about Crewners. What was, in particular, the inspiration for a one-chair barbershop?
I wanted to bring back something from the past. I've always been interested in the nostalgia of the past and growing up that way. The one-chair barbershop was because I didn't want my first shop to have any of the drama that you find in maybe other barbershops or other salons. I knew I could make this a one-man show, and I could kind of control the atmosphere in here. And I wanted to go small on my first venture out.
How did you land here at San Pedro Square Market? How did that come about?
I was with a friend of mine who's an Italian chef, and he was bringing some raviolis here for the partners to the partners in Steve Borkenhagen when Steve's office was on Santa Clara. And he had asked if I could come in and meet with Steve. And I told him, well, this is kind of your deal. You should really. And he's, oh, no, he insisted that I come in and I meet Steve. So I sat in and I met with Steve. And Steve asked me what it was that I did. And I told him, well, I'm a barber. He took a few seconds and punched a few keys on his Mac computer and spun it around. And there on their merchant wish list was right around number 3233. It said one chair barbershop. And that was it. It was fate. And that was December 29th of 2009. And I was the first to sign a lease about 6 to 8 weeks after that.
Dan, I noticed that there's still a lot of construction going on here. And is there a time frame where this is going to end? Or I know, I guess, new places are coming in. What can you tell us about that?
As it stands right now, we're looking to be done with 90% of the building that we're in right now within the next 4 weeks. So before the first of the year, we should be completely, well, again, 90% done with this portion. The rest of the project, it's kind of a work in progress. They're still leasing some of the space, but right now I'm told that we're at about 75 to 80% leased out. It's just the permitting process and the contractors and what they're dealing with now. So a work in progress.
Saturday, and they're still working away. We can hear them sawing and hammering. So, yes. Dan, you have a love for the classics. So do I. Frank Sinatra, Dean Martin. How did this come about?
I started collecting early on. I used to go to sleep at night listening to Glenn Miller on AM radio. And I started collecting about 1977. My parents and my brother and I went to Hollywood in our motorhome to go to Disneyland in Knott's Berry Farm. And while we were down there, we stopped on Sunset in West Hollywood and picked up one of those maps of the stars' homes. We started driving around. We went to Groucho Marx's house, Maury Amsterdam, and we got up to this one house on Roxbury Drive, and it was where Jimmy Stewart lived. And back in those days, they didn't have large walls or surveillance cameras out in front of their homes. So I told my mom and dad that I wanted to go up and meet them, and they didn't stop me. They encouraged me to go up to the door, so I did. I went up to the door. I knocked on the door, and Mrs. Stewart answered the door. And I asked her if Mr. Stewart was home, and she said that he was in his den on a very important phone call. And I don't know what even prompted me to say this, but I told her, could you please tell him that Danny Dixon stopped by? And she said she'd do it. And right from there, I knew I wanted to be at least some part of that time. So the first autograph that I did receive back, I sent to Bob and Dolores Hope when they lived in Palm Desert. And I received that in 1978. And from there, just kind of kept going. I'd write to stars, whether it be at their homes or at the studios. And the collection that I have here pertains to the theme that I have going here. But I do have photos from Myrna Loy addressed to me, Wolfman Jack, a lot of, all the way from the late 20s, Clara Bow, Marion Davies, all the way up to about the 60s.
Fantastic. Well, I want to get some information about this legendary barber chair.
Yes.
And I want you to tell us all about it. So would you mind doing that?
I can do that.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you, Judy. The chair here is a 1931 Theo Cook's barber's chair. It was built in Chicago. It was in a barber shop in downtown Chicago for 36 years. This is a story that I'm told. It then traveled with the barber to Los Angeles via Route 66, and was in a barbershop in downtown LA for about 27 years. It was then sold by the family at a garage sale for $300 to the gentleman who I bought it from, and he had it in his den for about 4 years, and I found it on a certain website, and I saw it, and I saw the round seat, and that's what really drew me to it, and made a deal with him. But one of the things that I did was Rick Dale from Rick's Restoration and American Restoration on the History Channel. I sent him a photo of the chair, and he said that it's very rare to find not only the original headrest with the original chair, but that the cylinder here that holds the sanitary paper for the dispenser here is even more rare, and that the tube here, the cylinder, is worth about $300 or $400 unrestored. And so I told him the price, and he said that if I didn't buy it, that he would. So I drove down with some friends, and we bought it in El Monte, California, in April of 2010. And a week later, I drove it out to Rick Dale out in Las Vegas, and he restored it. He repowder coated the frame of it, root beer brown, had all of the nickel all redone and all re-chromed, and then the matte black cushion. And that's the beautiful centerpiece that I have today.
I hope you've enjoyed my interview with Dan Dixon, the owner of Crewners. He's on Facebook. Check him out. Also, his website is crewners.com. That's C-R-E-W-N-E-R-S, Crewners. Stay tuned.